Right, but we start today with the story of the Wellingtonian woman Penelope Mansell. Recently, she inquired at a women's gym about buying membership. The gym declined it as it did not consider her to be a woman. Penelope is transgender, and the trans community say her case now highlights how the law needs to be changed to address trans rights specifically. Now, they have their hopes set on a bill going through Parliament that will enable trans people to self-identify their gender. Here's Whena Owen and an exclusive interview with the woman who found herself at the centre of trans politics.
She just remained silent for about a minute and then said, "I'm sorry, dear, I'm going to have to ask you this question. Are you transgendered?"
But Wellingtonian Penny Mansell's answer to that question wasn't enough to grant her entry into this women's only gym. Penny was after a wins quote at Revive Fitness, and the gym happened to be the closest to where she was living.
She stated that it was the gym's policy not to let any transgendered person into the gym until they've had a medically certified sexual reassignment surgery. I informed her that A, it's not possible in New Zealand, B, it's a 40 to 50 year wait list.
Absolutely, it was out of line to ask that question.
Felix Desmarais writes on local trans issues.
They don't need to be asking her about whether she's had surgery. I'm sure they don't check every other woman's, you know, pants, underpants situation.
Penny showed the staff her birth certificate, which states she is female. Certificates are only changed if the person has undergone surgery or, in Penny's case, medical or hormonal treatment. But that wasn't enough.
What I got out of it was, first of all, it shed light on the issue that there's no support out there for particularly small businesses to know, well, what's the best thing to do here.
The trans community insist if someone just says they're a certain gender, they should be accepted as such. A week after the incident, the gym apologised to Penny.
They obviously made a mistake. It's pretty hard to blame them in a context where the government isn't even taking any leadership on trans discrimination themselves.
I think our trans community have always had a point in terms of specific recognition. Gender identity and gender expression is not in the Human Rights Act. And that's based on a Crown Law opinion that was received that said that gender identity is actually included under sex.
Well, Revive Fitness told us they couldn't appear on Q&A while they're reviewing their policy and working with the Human Rights Commission. But they did tell us that staff have been very stressed over this issue and have been confronted aggressively online and in person.
Innocent staff members were being targeted with abuse. Someone's car, I believe, was criminally damaged at her home residence. Very nasty, horrible, extreme people. And over the following week I learnt that there's differing groups from both sides of the argument.
That other side of the argument has resulted in clashes in Britain recently. Feminist groups keen to protect women's rights are a growing faction there. The iconic feminist Germaine Greer has been outspoken about trans rights and subsequently lost much of her platform.
I'm not saying that people should not be allowed to go through that procedure. What I'm saying is it doesn't make them a woman.
The heat around trans rights in Britain is because of the controversial gender recognition bill, which would allow anyone to self-declare their identity, no questions asked.
The rights of women and girls are under a large-scale wholesale attack from the trans rights movement.
That's the UK and their proposed legislation. What about us? Well, we're almost there when it comes to gender self-declaration. An amendment to the Births, Deaths and Marriages Act aims to enshrine that, and it's almost at its second reading.
UK want to move where we're moving to, which is about people being able to self-identify.
But have we attracted that sort of opposition?
And what I'm aware of through our process to a limited degree, but over in the UK, is that women's groups and some women actually have an issue about trans women being women.
There's a name for those feminist groups. What's a TERF, by the way?
A trans exclusionary radical feminist. So,
do we have some of those?
Of course we do.
Have you been called one?
I get called a TERF all the time.
Whena Owen says expressing her opinions made it impossible to continue to live and work in Wellington City.
It's almost overwhelming. I can't keep track of all the names I've been called and all the dictators, famous dictators I've been compared to.
Whena says at the moment there's heat around the Births, Deaths and Marriages Amendment going through the Select Committee. Louisa Wall acknowledges the bill is a significant social shift.
I actually think it's a profound change. I know some people won't like it, but that's their own prejudice.
This legislation that they're pushing completely undermines a lot of the work that the suffragists did. They fought for the women's vote because they wanted to give women a way of making political demands that pertain to our sex. We can't do that once the definition of what a woman is has fundamentally changed.
Women's health and equal pay statistics may be distorted, Whena claims. She wants all New Zealand women consulted before the law changes. Meanwhile, Penny tells us she's hoping for some good news from the gym, and her political advocate hopes an imminent law change will prevent this happening again.
It's quite simple, really. Penny's a woman, treat her like a woman.
Okay, Whena Owen reporting there, and if you have any issues as a result of our story, call the LGBTIQ+ support line on 0800 688 5463.